Hello, welcome to my channel Neoped Edu. In this short video, I want to talk about what kind of topics you should discuss with physicians treating your premature baby who is staying in NICU with diagnosis of apnea of prematurity. As a reminder, I'm Dr. Wisniewski and I am practicing neonatologist in the United States. And I also authored the book Babies Born Early. It is a book for parents of premature babies who are born at less than 32 weeks and are staying now in NICU. It will help you with that difficult journey of seeing your baby every day in NICU, and it will help you to learn about topics that probably you should discuss with doctors treating your baby in NICU. Let's get to our topic of the day. Questions that you should ask of your doctors treating your baby with apnea of prematurity. As a reminder, I would encourage you, if you haven't seen yet my previous video on apnea, in this video I presented definition, symptoms, diagnosis, treatment, and prognosis of apnea of prematurity. Here I want to mention what kind of questions you should discuss with doctors treating your baby for apnea of prematurity. So first question that should be asked is, how sure or how do you know that my baby has apnea of prematurity? We should understand that there are many other conditions that can cause apneic episodes in premature baby. Those conditions might be such as sepsis or infections, pneumonias, intraventricular hemorrhage, necrotizing enterocolitis, feeding intolerance, and many, many others. So it is important that doctors consider different conditions, and also before starting the treatment for apnea of prematurity, that we make sure that your baby indeed has apnea of prematurity. Another question that probably you want to know is how often or how severe apneic episodes are in your baby. The episodes may differ in its severity. We describe apneic episode severity by telling how many symptoms per day baby has, how long are those symptoms, and what is happening during those symptoms. What I mean by that is how low oxygen goes down, for how long that apnea persists, is it accompanied by low heart rate, also called bradycardia, and also does your baby require stimulation by hand from the nurse or another health worker to start breathing again? Or in some rare situations, does your baby require resuscitation or positive pressure ventilation in order to recover from apnea? So all that information might be helpful for you to understand severity of the condition of that apnea of prematurity that your baby was diagnosed with. Another question you might want to ask is how much of respiratory support your baby needs. It is understandable that your baby who is premature and is staying in NICU probably has many other accompanying medical conditions, and very frequently your baby will have premature lung disease later on evolving into bronchopulmonary dysplasia, maybe pneumonia, infections, or some other conditions requiring respiratory support. The degree of respiratory support also might be very different depending on severity of lung condition. Some babies may just require nasal cannula, which is a plastic tubing in the nose with some airflow and addition of oxygen if needed. Some babies will require to be treated with nasal CPAP device. And finally, in most severe situations, some babies will be placed on the ventilator. It would be interesting to know, or good to know for you, whether additional diagnosis of apnea of prematurity in your baby made your baby require more respiratory support. So you probably would know how much that respiratory support changed in your baby due to occurrence of apnea of prematurity. Things to pay attention are amount of flow when baby is on nasal cannula, amount of oxygen concentration whenever your baby is on any kind of respiratory support, and amount of respiratory rates or pressures when your baby is on the ventilatory support. So all these questions you can ask of your doctors, and they will gladly tell you what kind of respiratory support your baby is on and what is changing from day to day. Another question that you probably want to ask is, are any medical treatments that we started for your baby in order to treat apnea of prematurity? The most commonly used medication is caffeine. It's a chemical substance also present in tea or coffee, and this chemical substance makes us be more alert, more active, and it does the same pretty much for the baby. It makes your baby breathe more regularly. So caffeine is very frequently used for treatment of apnea of prematurity. It might be not necessary for the mildest cases of apnea of prematurity, but in most babies, actually, this treatment is indeed started. So if your baby was started on that medication, you may also want to know how your baby responded. Did number of episodes, apneic episodes, changed? Did severity of apneic episodes changed? And finally, you also would want to know probably whether your baby has any side effects from treatment with caffeine. The most commonly seen side effects or accompanying symptoms when we treat baby with caffeine is increased heart rate and sometimes some mild feeding intolerance. Finally, if your baby is stable, tolerating feedings, growing and outgrowing apnea of prematurity, you will want to know when your baby can go home. What are criteria? After how many days of being free of apnea of prematurity, your baby can go home? After how many days after your baby's caffeine was stopped, your baby can go home? So some institutions have different opinions on those decisions when your baby that had previously been treated with caffeine or had diagnosis of apnea, when they can go home. So you probably also want to ask this question. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel, Neoped Edu. And also, if you do have baby that is premature, born at less than 32 weeks and staying in an ICU right now, you may be interested to check out my book, Babies Born Early. I submitted the link to Amazon where you can buy this book. Thank you for watching.